What is up, my hoopers? It is Manny here, back with another video, and today I'm going to be showing you guys, the viewers, subscribers, everyone, how to shoot the ball like Damian Lillard. These keys are perfect to implement into your game today. You can literally go out to the gym right now and do exactly what I'm about to tell you, and you're going to see some success. And as you practice these over and over and over again, you're going to be shooting the ball like Damian Lillard in literally no time. So without further ado, let's get into the keys. Key number one, balance and square to the basket. You'll see Damian Lillard a lot of times, he's got a strong base and he's pointed to the basket. He might have his hip up a little bit pointing to the basket, but he's got a really strong base. He's on balance so he can guide where he wants the ball to go. So you'll see right here, Damian sets his feet, keeps his balance, and even though it's a deep shot, he's got his balance, strong base. He can get it up there and really knock it down. And you'll see right here, I'll slow it down. See, he plants those 2 feet and just raises up. And you know, some people are gonna say it's too deep of a shot, but when you have balance, you've got a strong base, you know, you can make these kind of shots. You can knock these kind of shots down. He's living proof of it, and he works at it. But you'll see it again. Plants the feet, strong base, and then rises up and knocks it down. Key number two, shoot with your legs and not your arms. Now, I know this is maybe a little confusing, but this essentially just means start from the bottom up. Don't try to push the ball out with your arms, pushing as hard as you can. Just because you shoot like this, you, does not mean you need to push it out and try to force it to the basket. Start from your legs. Great shooters start from the ground up. They start from the feet into their legs and then into the shot. And this is the easy part. That's the part that's muscle memory. That's the easy part. Shoot from your legs. You'll see Damian always shoot from the ground up. He gets a nice bend and he's always shooting from the ground up, and he's not pushing the ball to the rim, because you can't guide it when you're pushing it to the rim. So this one goes hand in hand with balance, but you'll see right here, nice strong leg bend. And when I say, you know, shoot from your legs, not your arms, you see the nice strong leg bend, and that's just him gaining power. You see how deep he is out. He's far out, far away from the goal. He just, that slight bend, doesn't have to be huge, but gets a nice bend and starts from the ground up. And then his arms are just, you know, the guiding point to guide the ball directly into the rim. But the shot is coming from his legs. And you'll see bend and then just raise up, and you have the muscle memory in your arms. Your arms really don't do a lot of the work. It's your lower body hitting the bend and then raising up and knocking it down. Key number three, one fluid motion. Now, you'll see a lot of people with different shots and different ways of shooting, and whatever's comfortable for you, you need to do that. But to shoot like Logo Lillard, you got to have a fluid motion shot. And when I say that, I mean the second you set the ball and you go up to shoot, there's no hitch. It's just one fluid, like water, one fluid motion. It's not like set, clock, shoot. It's one fluid motion. So right here, one fluid motion. This is a major key right here. Shout out DJ Khaled. This is a major key. You see Damian Lillard, he comes down and it's all one fluid motion. The ball never stops from when he sets the ball into his shooting pocket. And he does this because it eliminates, you know, a lot of error that could come from having two separate motions. When you have two separate motions, you know, things have to be perfect, things have to be aligned, you know, a lot has to go right for the shot to fall, for it to be a perfect shot. With a one fluid motion shot, it you know, it is what it is. It's fluid, it goes right up right into your shot. You have a little bit more room for error because it's that one fluid motion. You don't have a lot of herky jerky in it. And, you know, you'll find as you're more fluid, you know, the ball comes off smoother and, you know, you're going to find yourself making a lot more shots if you just have this one motion all the way up, all the way into your follow through. Key number four, space. So you'll see Damian Lillard, he makes shots over big guys, over the people guarding him, over, you know, over a lot of the defenders right in his face. But what you will notice is that the majority of his shots, he's creating space and he's got a wide open look. It might be very deep out, you know, he's Logo Lillard, but he's always creating space so that it's a clear shot for him to the basket. And, you know, Damian Lillard is not that tall. He's one of the shortest guards in the NBA. He's only like 6'1", so he needs that space away from, you know, the 6'7", 6'8 guys. And creating space allows you to get a good clean look virtually anywhere you are on the floor. So if you can go out and create some space, you can get a good look. You know, it might be deep, might be not in a spot that you're comfortable with, but if you can create space, you can get a nice look and you should feel confident that you can knock it down. So I'm sure a lot of you have seen this shot right here, but this goes hand in hand with this key in creating space. And although he's very deep out right now and probably could have shot it without taking a step back, Damian Lillard is an elite space getter, a space creator. He, and you see right here, it's really simple. Just a little sidestep to get that extra centimeter, extra inch of space to get an open look. You know, Paul George is guarding him. Paul George is 6'9". Damian Lillard is 6'1". Paul George has 8 inches on him. So he has to, you know, have that little bit of a sidestep. And that's all he needs to get a shot off and get a good look off. So creating space is vital because you're going to have a defender on you in the game. Before we go any further with the tips, make sure you hit the like button, hit the subscribe button. It really, really, really helps the channel out. It's going to allow me to continue to provide these tips and tricks that I've gathered over my lifetime. And I'll be able to give them to you so you guys can excel your game and take it to the next level. So make sure you hit that like and subscribe button. Please, please, please. Key number five, confidence, repetition. Confidence, repetition. Confidence, repetition. I'll do it one more time. Confidence, repetition. Damian Lillard does not shoot any shots in the game. I repeat, he does not shoot any shots in the game that he has not practiced and practiced and practiced. And that's virtually it. And confidence comes from that repetition. And you'll see when he shoots the ball, every shot's the same. Every shot's the same. And he might be moving a different way. He might jump, you know, to the left a little bit more because the defender's on the right. He makes adjustments. But when you get to this spot right here, when he gets to the shot and the follow through, it is the same every single time. And that's that repetition. That's the muscle memory. So when you're out at the gym with your friends or trying to make your high school team or whatever it is, have that repetition. Prepare, shoot those shots over and over again. And when it comes to game time, you'll get the results. The results will come just from the repetition and shooting those same shots. It can get boring. It can get boring, but I promise you, boring is good when it comes to shooting and honing in those skills. Repetition, repping it out, doing it a bunch of times, and that's gonna grow that confidence. So then when it's game time, you're shooting like Damian Lillard. You're coming off the screen, knocking it down, same shot every time, and just an elite scorer, an elite shooter, and no one can stop you. So right here, this is what I talk about, confidence, repetition. Makes a really nice move at the top of the key, breaks his defender off, gets a lot of space like we talked about. But this one, you know, on the move, feet might not be as set as how he would normally like it, but because of that repetition, because of that confidence, he can still get into his one motion shot and still get it off, and it's still a deep shot, but because he's got that repetition, because he has that, you know, confidence that he's built up over time, you can be a little off on your balance. You can be a little off on some of the mechanics that you that you've been practicing, just because you have that repetition, you have that muscle memory, and you've got that confidence to really raise up and knock it down no matter what the circumstances are. My sixth tip, self-explanatory, you probably heard it a lot, but hold the follow through. I promise you, if you implement this into your game, literally the next time you play, your shooting percentage will go up. This is an underrated tip. If you watch Dame, there will be times when he has to flick it and throw the arms back or flick it and flail to try to get the foul. But for the most part, when he's shooting his shots, I cannot stress this enough, holds that gooseneck right there, holds that, holds the follow through. I'm telling you, your shooting percentage will go up 10 to 15%, give or take a few percentage points. If you shoot it, have that confidence and hold that follow through. I promise you guys, that is one of the most underrated keys in basketball. And it's kind of lost its value because, you know, in the NBA, a lot of guys are falling away, shooting it. These guys are elite talents. These guys are at the top of the game, best in the world. They can get away with stuff like that. But as we're continuing to grow our game and get better and better, hold that follow through. I promise it will help you make more shots, which will help you build more confidence, which will help you add points per game to your stats. And I mean, we all want to, you know, get to that 20, 25, 30, 35 points per game. So make sure you hold that follow through. Those are my tips, guys. If you implement those six tips into your game today, the next time you go play basketball, I promise you will see strides of improvement. And you keep doing those over and over and over again, and in no time, you'll be shooting out there from 35, 40 feet like Damian Lillard. You'll be knocking them down, have that stone cold killer face on with so much confidence added to your game. You're gonna surprise yourself, I'm telling you. Watch this video over and over again. Use the tips. Write them down. Keep them in your head. Use them. Go to the gym. Practice them. And I promise you, shooting percentage will go up. Points per game will go up. You know, you will be start getting more respect as a shooter, as someone that needs to be prioritized on the defensive end so they can stop you. I'm telling you, these keys will help you excel in your game and take you to new levels that you didn't even think you could get to. Thank you guys for tuning in so much. I really enjoy doing these videos. Make sure you leave a like, a comment, subscribe. It really does help me out and allows me to provide more videos and more how-tos, more tips, more tricks, and it helps me help you to excel your basketball game to the highest possible level you can reach.